In previous lecture, we have seen our development in our society, how society helps us in our individual's development. Today, we are going to see 1.4, that is, what is meant by a society. अगर आपको पूछा जाए society मतलब क्या? सिर्फ crowd of people मतलब society है? No. सोसाइटी में हर कोई शामिल है. यस, इंस्टीट्यूशंस, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, अवर फैमिलीज, अवर रिलेटिव, ऑल दे कम टुगेदर एंड दैट इज अवर सोसाइटी. हियर डेफिनेशन इज गिवन अबाउट सोसाइटी. इट इज नॉट अ सिंपली एज अ मॉब और अ क्राउड ऑफ अ पीपल. इट इज अ पीपल कम टुगेदर for achieving a certain common objective is called society. Okay, so let's start with this topic, that is, what is meant by society. Society includes all people, man, woman, grown-ups, old people, young children, etc. Our families are part of our society. Society also includes different groups, institutions and organizations. The interrelationship and interaction between people, their dependence on one another and sharing also form a part of society. Society is not simply a mob of crowd of people. Society is formed when people come together to achieve certain common objective. Okay. मतलब what do you mean by society? Society includes all our every man, woman, young children, old, all are being together comes for a common objective is called a society. In society, we can include the groups, institutions, and organization. Why is it so? Because we are interrelation with them. Okay, we are being interdependent on each other. That's why society is being formed. In order to fulfill our needs like food, clothing, shelter and security, the society has to create a permanent system. Without such system, the day-to-day affairs of the society cannot be carried. A system is essential for continued existence of the society. For example, agriculture. Okay, मतलब हमारी जो रोजमर्रा की जिंदगी में लगने वाली जो चीजें हैं, clothing, food, shelter, needs जो है हमारे जो basic needs हैं, उसके लिए भी एक permanent system बनाया गया है. जब तक एक proper system ना हो, चलन ना हो, तब तक हमारी जो day to day affairs है, वो smoothly functioning नहीं कर सकती. Okay. Because of that, a system is essential for the continuing existence of the society. For example, agriculture is essential to fulfill the need for food. Agriculture का इतनी important है, हमारी जो सबसे basic need है, that is food. To fulfill that need, agriculture is important. Various institutions must be created to perform all the functions related to agriculture. अब agriculture से related और भी बहुत सारी चीजें हैं. Agriculture क्या के लिए है? हमारी need fulfill करने के लिए food की. लेकिन agriculture को लगने वाली बहुत सारी चीजें हैं, जैसे कि क्या है? Raw material. Raw material में क्या आता है? Manures, fertilizers, crops, grains. Yes, and the manpower is needed, some machineries are needed, market is needed. Okay, very important, that is, market is needed. Various institutions must be created to perform all the functions related to agriculture. Therefore, a vast system needs to be created. मतलब, food के लिए एक बड़ा vast system होना जरूरी होता है. और वो अगर system ना हो, तो ये properly functioning होगा क्या? No. Vast system needs to be created, which include factories of manufacturing. the farmers a market for a good produce, etc. The existence of such system makes society stable. Okay, ये अगर system है तो ही हम हमारी society में stability ला सकते हैं. We can be stable. बराबर. In the next chapter, we shall learn about the diversity in Indian society. So students, we have completed our chapter here. In this chapter, important points you have to underline and write in your notebook. After that, I will send you PDF form question answer. Even you can try to write the fill in the blanks and one line sentences answers in your notebook.